In this video, I'm going to take you through the configuration for 802.1x on our Connect Series amplifiers. So on my screen here, I've got the web UI up. I've got an amplifier here, and I will take you through how to configure 802.1x. So to get to that configuration page, you'll first click on the amp info button. And there's now a section here for 802.1x. So we can click on that, and now you can see here that there's the settings for it. And the first drop down here is for mode. By default, the amp will come with 802.1x disabled. If you click on this, you can see that we support three different modes. So PEAP, TLS, and TTLS. And each one of these modes has a slightly different set of information that you have to put into it. So we'll start with PEAP. So in this mode, it's pretty straightforward. There's two required fields, one for identity and one for password. So we can type in the identity here and the password. Once you've completed the required fields, there are a couple of optional fields below here for anonymous identity and domain. You can enter the information here if you have it from your IT administrator, but it's not required to get PEAP mode working. So once you've entered all the appropriate information, just like the network settings page on the amplifier, you have to click the save button in the top right-hand corner to push these settings to the amplifier. So I will do that here, and now you get a pop-up warning here. So it says saving 802.1x settings may cause the amplifier to temporarily disconnect from the network. That's because as it applies the settings, it resets the network adapter so that it boots up with the proper 802.1x settings that you've just entered. So we'll click save. This is going to kick off the network here for a second, most likely, and then it should come back in just a second. And that one did it so quickly, we didn't even see it disconnect. Now for the other modes, TLS and TTLS, these both require certificates. So in TLS mode here, you still have the identity, and now it is the key file password rather than the password for the user. And below that, still the optional anonymous identity and domain. But now at the bottom here, you have some information and some buttons to upload certificates. So for TLS mode, you need three different files. One is the CA certificate, the second is the client certificate, and then third is the key file. So these all get uploaded one by one. And I'll show you how to do that here. So I'll upload the CA certificate first. I've got on my desktop, I have a folder with some test certificates here. So we'll upload the CA certificate here. So you select the file and you click open. This is loading it into the amp. It says there's an error right now, but it's just processing as it's getting the certificate, and it'll show you some information here. So now it's processed that certificate. And now you can see here under CA certificate, there is an uploaded section, and it gives you the current, the start period and the end validity period for that certificate. So you can tell that you've got the latest certificate that you need. Same thing for the client cert and the key file. So I'll upload these really quickly here as well. And now you can see that it's populating some information here that we've got uploaded start and end date for the CA cert, uploaded start and end date for the client cert, and the key file, there is a file uploaded. So when you do this, these files are basically staged on the amp. They are not live yet. They will go live when you click the save button. So this will allow you to update your certificates without breaking your 802.1x authentication, so you can put all the new files in and then click save, and it will push them all up at once in the amp to all be used at the same time. So I can click save here. Same pop-up warning again. We will save these. It may disconnect the amp, it may not. Once it all goes through, we'll see this kick over here. Yep, the amp just disconnected. It reconnected here. And now you can see we have the same information, but instead of being in the uploaded section for each one of these, it is now in the active section for these. So now after we click the save button, these certificate and key files are now active on the amp, and it will give you the same validity information and tell you that the RSA key is okay. It does a little check on that with the password. pretty much the same here for TTLS mode, except you're only required to have a CA certificate. You don't have the other two files. It's all done in the same way that I just took you through. So there you have it. That's 802.1x on our amplifier. Feel free to use it in those secured networks where it's absolutely required, and let us know what you think.